So when you focus on your testicles, you're literally charging your batteries. What do your balls feel like right now? Smile into that feeling. And what I really want to say is that gay panic has been brainwashed into all of our psyches, because these types of activities release high amounts of testosterone. They lower competition and comparison. It's a sense of de-armoring. You're basically blessing your nuts for the upliftment of all of humanity, and you're increasing the frequency of the mini brain of your gonads by smiling and growling into them.
taking the coconut oil and milking your penis down 50 times, up 50 times, left 50 times, right 50 times, and straight out 50 times every day. Two men hugging heart to heart with the cocks touching, breathing, and doing our best to stay in a parasympathetic state of being rather than going into stress mode. So for most of my life, I couldn't feel my balls. Now that I do this ritual regularly, I can actually feel the sperm being produced in my balls, and I feel so much more grounded. But I'm just saying, let your cock and your balls fully exist in the form that they're meant to exist in, beyond the poisoning.
and I teach sexual kung fu. The sad truth is that cock size is the smallest it's ever been in recorded history.
Oh my God, the wild naked man denies the existence of viruses, and he just like talks about all this crazy shit that I didn't learn about, and I've been going to med school for 5 generations, okay?
Did you actually read the links that I sent?
Oh my God, just accept that you're gay. You're gay, you're gay, you're gay, honey.
My balls used to be the size of like like slightly bigger than an almond, and now they're both the size of like a Brazil nut.
The penis and the tongue are the outermost extensions of the heart. In classical Chinese medicine, you're just like, brother, you've got a beautiful cock.
Get as much sperm into their bodies as they can because they believe it, like, it's got testosterone in it too, that they are like increasing their manhood. Like, people would like draw cocks in my mouth on my student council posters, and I guess they assumed that I was gay because I was a singer. I mean, yeah, I definitely have same-sex attraction. the more I do same-sex erotic bonding, the more pussy I want to eat. So that men can feel more juicy and primal and wild. So in my classes, we get naked and we literally massage our cocks together. They actually have to suck as much cock as they can before they hit the age of 20 or 21, and then they can marry a woman.
My testicles attract girls from all over the world. My balls produce massive amounts of testosterone.
I started to get into other modalities. I was like, I need more. And also I got addicted to cocaine. Drinking my piss gets me kind of high. I don't know how it works. Semen retention.
Suspend the breath, squeeze your anus, sex organ, navel. Shunt the energy up your spine into your pineal. So that doesn't mean you never ejaculate. It means that you increase the time between ejaculating. I mean, if we think about it, a whole new baby can be created from an ejaculation.
we wrote what we wanted to let go of, and we ejaculated onto it. High on your own supply, baby. People always say, Will, can I really grow my penis? And I say, yeah, just fucking pull on it.
It's about connecting to your balls, your cock, your tribe, and Mother Earth.